When I first got a boyfriend at age 18, I thought I knew everything. I'd watched the videos, I'd read the articles, I was ready, I wanted to have sex. But as is the experience of many people, the first attempt didn't go exactly according to plan, and everything I thought I knew flew out the window and I panicked. None of the videos or articles had prepared me. So where could I turn? The internet had betrayed me. So I went to a friend. We went for coffee, I told her my woes, she shared her experiences, we laughed, and then she gave me good, practical advice. I was calmed, reassured, and before not too long, having successful sex. That experience taught me a lot, and it taught me things that none of those videos or articles had. It taught me that sex really isn't that scary. Really, it's just something to have a laugh about with your friends. I have carried that experience with me, and I've tried to return the favor to as many people as possible. And that's what I'm here today to do. Today we're thinking about odysseys, and our sexual lives can seem like just that, an epic journey that we take throughout our lives. And just like Odysseus, we face obstacles along the way. Just when you think you're on the right path, something comes along and turns everything upside down. But I believe that the way we as a society think about sex makes this particular journey harder than it has to be. And there's a really simple solution: talking. My name is Susannah Shepherd, and I'm a regular university student. I'm not a sexpert, and this is not a sex education lesson. I am far from knowing everything there is to know about sex. But so are you. Human sexuality is simply too broad, evolving, and subjective for one person to know everything there is to know. And I couldn't possibly address every issue related to sexuality in a neatly timed slot. So we're all informed by our own experiences, and I would only be able to share my own relatively limited knowledge with you. So that isn't what I'm here today to do. Instead, I'm proposing that we should all be sharing this fragmentary knowledge that we have with each other. I believe that open and honest conversations about sex not only improve our sex lives as individuals, but have the power to change the way we as a society view sex for the better. Now, that might not sound particularly innovative, and you may think I sound a bit like a hippie claiming we should all hold hands in a circle and share our feelings. But we do not live in a society where people feel free to talk about their own sex lives. There is a paradox in the way we think about sex. Whilst it suffuses nearly every aspect of our pop culture, people do not feel able to have productive conversations about the natural and realistic aspects of our own sex lives. The majority of university students are sexually active. So the majority of us here today are having sex. The majority of us are studying, and we talk about that. The majority of us are going to the gym, and we talk about that. Why is sex any different from any other part of our everyday lives? Paradoxically, we live in a sex-obsessed world where we cannot talk about sex. I believe that talking about these issues can educate people on a wide variety of issues. But let's take, for example, sexual health. We all have gaps in our knowledge, and though people are sexually active, they may not know essential safe sex practices. For example, a friend of mine was unaware that the pill, the morning after pill, is effective for 72 hours after the sexual encounter. Its effectiveness reduces over that time. Another friend of mine was unaware that urinating before and after vaginal penetrative intercourse can help prevent UTIs. And these were both women who had been sexually active for a long time and considered themselves educated on the matter. According to Public Health England, the impact of STDs remains greatest amongst heterosexual individuals aged 18 to 24. And according to the Center for Disease Control, individuals aged 15 to 24 are at a higher risk of acquiring an STD. Furthermore, as a young, sexually active woman, I can attest that navigating the world of contraception is a nightmare. There are so many options, from the pill, the IUD, the implant, the injection, and choosing which one is right for you can be difficult and scary. I believe that if we have open conversations, we are more likely to talk about what protection we're using, our experiences with it, and hold other people accountable for lax protection. Nobody wants an STD, and hopefully talking about them will help reduce the risk of you getting one. but it will also reduce the stigma around what has become a relatively common issue for young people today. Clearly, sexual health is still an issue that needs addressing. However, school-based sex education has focused almost exclusively on these negative consequences of sex, neglecting arguably the most important and basic lesson there is to be taught, that it's fun. It was Michelle Fine who first discussed an absence of a discourse of desire in school-based sex education. She and subsequent scholars have argued that candid discussions of pleasure and desire increase our sexual agency and in turn lead to healthier sexual behaviors. Studies have shown young women who receive sex-positive education and express sex-positive views are more responsible users of contraception and are less likely to engage in high-risk sexual behaviors. Furthermore, a study showed that young women whose mothers candidly discussed pleasure and desire with them reported a higher level of pleasure in their first sexual encounter. Treating pleasure and desire as something to be ashamed of, or worse, something that doesn't even exist, deprives young people of all the joys and intimacies that sex can bring. There is still so much stigma surrounding female masturbation, whereas young men are encouraged to explore their bodies and their sexualities. Contrary to popular beliefs that talking about these types of things will lead young people into negative behaviors, the more candid our discussions and the less shame that suffuses them, the healthier our sexual decisions become. Making those healthy sexual decisions can be really hard in today's society. The cultural narratives available to us do not always depict healthy sexual relationships. Take, for example, the 50 Shades of Grey series, which depicts a BDSM relationship, which stands for bondage, dominance, sadism, masochism. The relationship often exhibits toxic behaviors, and this and other narratives have normalized and popularized abuse. Seeing these violent, controlling behaviors have taught young people that this is the kind of behavior they should accept and expect from their sexual encounters. And a way we can tackle these misconceptions is by having open conversations, asking people when something feels wrong, getting an outside perspective. From inside a toxic relationship, those behaviors can start to feel normal, which is why making our sexual lives open is such an important step towards making our sex lives better as individuals. And it isn't just how you're having sex that is stigmatized, but whether you're having it at all, and if so, how much. Not having sex is a perfectly valid choice, whether you're waiting until marriage, on the asexual spectrum, just aren't ready, or for any other reason. But our society treats not having sex as something that's wrong and makes those who choose not to feel less than. Virginity is a socially constructed, heteronormative concept that is in no way a reflection of your worth. I am saying this as someone who is speaking from experience. In the diary I kept when I was in sixth form, I wrote as a New Year's resolution that I wanted to lose my virginity. And if I'm being honest, I definitely wrote that down more than once. I felt like everyone around me was having sex, and I felt that there must be something wrong with me because I wasn't. And on the other end of the spectrum, you have people who have too much sex. It seems that we can't win either way. More transparency about our sexual lives will let people in on the secret that everyone wishes their number was different. And the even bigger secret, that that number really doesn't matter at all. I believe that these open conversations lead to better, healthier sexual lives. But there is a more serious issue that needs addressing. Whilst there is still so much taboo and stigma surrounding our sexuality, there is an undeniable rape culture that pervades. So, whilst people feel unable to have these productive conversations, so-called jokes about assault are fair game. A recent group chat from a group of students at the University of Warwick in the UK was uncovered to be full of rape jokes. And similar incidences can be seen throughout North America and Europe. I'm not naive enough to believe that conversations will stop sexual assault. Forced sex has been an aspect of society since antiquity, and I imagine will pervade for the end of human existence. But I do believe that we live in a society that dismisses the kind of humor that condones assault without holding people accountable. And the voices of the many are stronger than the voices of the few. Recent events that have unfolded in the entertainment industry have shown that when one person speaks out, it encourages others to do so. Conversations can open the door to deconstructing this culture that makes people feel unsafe. And a culture where people feel safe is a culture where we can begin to take meaningful steps towards reducing sexual assault, such as prosecuting perpetrators. So, what am I actually proposing that you do? I'm not suggesting that you shout your favorite sex position from the rooftops or do anything that makes you feel uncomfortable. Take baby steps. Be open to listening, and if and when it feels right, share. Ask a friend for advice or share a funny story. I treat my sexual life like an open book. I talk about it with friends, family, and strangers. I believe that has not only enriched my sexual life, but my life as a whole. What I am proposing is that you share in those same benefits. Make sex something you are willing to share with the people around you. Dinner table conversation. Together, we can prove that sex does not have to be a dirty word. Thank you.